Gold rallied again, as it discussed in our Asia and Europe session update, that beyond 2048, it is 2055, and beyond 2055, we may look forward to 2060 and 2070 plus plus levels. Now, it has already achieved 2063. Does it mean that it is going to rally further highs towards 2070 plus plus level? And is fierce, which position you should take and at what levels? We will see. Likewise, oil so far had shied away from $75 levels. It has again come back to 74.2. Now, I hope you all profited so far with gold and oil. Now, what to expect with the US session? Which position you should take? We will see with the help of charts and indicators. This is the second update for the day. And if you are new to the channel, do subscribe to the channel to get the latest. You can also become the member of the channel to get the added perks. There is a join button. You can join. Now, let's start with the hourly charts. Now, see one point here that gold has left a little gap here at 2047 levels. Yes, there is a gap, but at the same time, you must note that there is a very strong base it has created at 2048-2047. So far for the day, after forming a narrowing triangle, we have seen gold rising high, and it has come to the resistance here at 2060-2065. Now, see, a good megaphone is formed. It is trying to consolidate. Now, you have to wait for it to break out beyond 2064-65 levels. Once it breaks out beyond 2064-65, we are looking at a target of 2071.5-2075. And in fact, it can rise further above those levels. MACD. Now, see, 20 period moving average is sitting a little far at 2050 levels, but it has started to diverge and moving averages are looking upwards. Thus, more bullishness can be seen. Stochastic overbought, MACD is divergent and bullish, looking upwards. RSI is overbought as well. Coming to 2-hour charts, similar observation on the 2-hour charts. Price is taking the support from the 20 period. Now, it has formed a good base. Moving average is diverging here, and price is looking upward. See, increasing body size, that is something you should note. Second point is a little wick left on the upside, which suggests that it can still give a further breakout. And this time, if it breaks out beyond 64-65, we are going to look forward to a very, very strong candle, which will take it towards 72 and 75 levels. The stochastic rising here, MACD divergent, MACD is bullish. RSI is also overbought currently. Coming to 3-hour chart. On the 3-hour charts, rise, retracement, formed a base, then one bullish candle, second bullish candle here. And there is a possibility of a third bullish candle. If you see, it is staying above 64-65, a massive bullish candle can be expected. Yes, now the prices have started to diverge from the moving average, thus it can continue to climb and wait for the moving average to climb up as well. Certainly a bullish sign. Stochastic overbought, MACD divergent and bullish, RSI overbought as well. Coming to 4-hour, likewise on the 4-hour charts, higher highs are seen, higher lows are seen. Thus, on the upside, 2070-2075 zone, the target here. On the downside, support very, very strong at 2050. As long as now 2050 is respected, we are not going to treat gold as bearish. Yes, also if you look at 3 candles, consolidated, one breakout, and then this continuation of the bullishness. Stochastic overbought, MACD has started to diverge. Good sign for the bulls. It is looking upwards. It can continue to rise. Look at the formation here, rise, retracement, and again looking upwards. RSI looking upwards as well. Coming to the daily chart. Now, before we look into the daily charts and I give you the levels, if you want to learn this art of trading, you can join my 28th mentorship batch. It is starting in January 2024. Register yourself, equip yourself with the simple strategies which can help you identify the profitable trades and help you trade profitably. Join the mentorship batch now itself. Visit the platform forexfunda.com, and if you just want to trade as per the signals, you can join my signals. Tomorrow we have a educational free webinar coming up where we are going to discuss, and I am going to share key strategies for you so that you can trade profitably. Do not miss to join this free webinar. Register yourself. The link is shared in my channel description, video description, and the communities tab. If you don't find it there, visit the platform www.forexfunda.com for more details. This link is there on my channel page, and else you can be part of my free Telegram channel where you can get the details. Additional to that, we have a paid webinar coming Sunday where we discuss what to expect from the markets in the coming week. We take a holistic view of indicators. We have to take a holistic view of markets, indices, commodities, and currency along with the volatility index. And I take your live questions there as well. So do join this. It comes with two free consultations where you can discuss with me anything and everything, be it a futuristic prediction you want me to make or your existing trades, anything we can discuss. Now, look at the daily charts. On the daily charts, see, first of all, preceding two candles, higher lows here. Here was the resistance. It has given a breakout yesterday and today it has formed a tail already, and with that as tail, it has formed the foundation for it to continue to give a bullish candle. Now, yesterday was a bigger bullish candle. Today, I expect it to be a further big bullish candle, which can take the prices, in fact, towards 2080 levels as well. We have to be very, very watchful. Yes, there is still bullish momentum seen here. We have to be trading with caution. If you see the price is staying above 2064.65, you can initiate a buying position. You can expect 2071, 2075 levels as the next targets. And then I will look forward to 2083.84 as the next target for the day. On the downside, a selling entry at 2050. But then remember, it is still to be traded with caution because 2047.48, very nearby support levels. And then below that, we can see 2046.45 as a very, very strong support. So once, as long as 2045 is respected, do not treat gold as bearish. It can bounce back strongly as well. So take your trades accordingly. Selling entries are certainly at far below levels. Yes, you can sell here at 2055.54 as well, but we have to be very, very cautious with that sell entry. Now let's have a look at crude oil. See, crude oil today finding the resistance close to 74.875 zone. As we discussed in our update, it has seen a fall. It has come towards 74 levels. Now 74 certainly is a very, very good support. 74.73.8. Once you see the price is staying below 73.8, you can look forward to further drop towards 73.5, 73.6 levels, and below that 73 are the next major. Also, if you look at the preceding candle, symmetrical formation, first breakout, and look at the, it is still trading in this channel where it has hit a bottom. Thus, only a break below 73.8 will confirm the bearishness, else prices can reverse as well. A stochastic looking downwards, MACD is on the verge of a crossover. This is a bearish cross. RSI looking down as well, coming to 2 hours. Now, oil on the 2 hour charts has consolidated strongly before giving this breakout candle. And yes, see, the previous two candles has got a push from the upside and it has come to the median of the Bollinger Bands and the 20 period moving average. Now, this is certainly a great, great support zone. Be careful at around 74, 73.8, only a drop below which you can confirm that we can see further sharper drop in oil here. Now, if you notice here, oil may try to form this channel where the bottom is far below at 72. A stochastic looking down, MACD after seeing a drop, it is converged and now again trying to cross over for sale, but it is still in green. It has not yet crossed over. So as long as you do not see a crossover here, do not treat oil as bearish, which means 73.8, 74 certainly going to provide a support. Coming to 3 hours, now look at 3 hour charts. See, it has breached this channel. It has come to the support levels. It has come to the 20 period moving average and to the median of divergence, median of the 20, median of the Bollinger Bands. Thus, if you see, once again the price is above 74.6, you can buy and expect 75.2. Now, only above 75.2, we can say that the prices have reversed and it is going to fly high. As long as 75.2 is not taken, not breached, do not treat oil as bullish. Stochastic overbought, MACD bearish here, RSI looking down. On the 4 hour chart, see, it is same breakout is seen. Now we have to wait for it to break out beyond 74.6 levels, and possibly this could happen with the next candle only, and thus we have to wait here. Beyond 74.6 is where we can see prices rising, else it is still trading bearish. Only thing was, it was divergent from the median of the Bollinger Bands. It is converged towards the median. It can in fact move towards the 20 period moving average sitting at 73.8. Thus, this zone becomes a great, great support for crude oil. Stochastic overbought, MACD is trading with slight bearishness. It is crossed over at the top. RSI is looking down. Coming to the daily chart. Now, look at the daily chart's higher highs, and it has a potential to give a breakout as well. We have to wait for a breakout, and this breakout can bring extreme bullishness. Right now, it is not showing much of the signs. We have to be careful, but later in the day, there is a potential that it can, though it is, if you look at it, is trading in this channel where the support levels are far below at 73 and the top of this channel is at 76. So this is a complete zone where we may see oil swinging in between. We have to be trading with caution in between these levels. Stochastic overbought, MACD is divergent and bullish. We have seen this earlier in our update that this is double bottom and it can continue to rise. That is what has happened. RSI is rising as well. Considering this, sell at 73.8 and buy at 74.7 levels, 74.6 levels. Be careful at around 75, 75.2, above which you can expect 76 as the next target. So on the downside, be careful at around 73.4, 73.6 as the first target. If you are selling at 73.8, 74 levels, yes, 73.4, 73.6 is the first support zone and then 73. Only below 73, the bears will take over and then 72 can be seen. Take your trades accordingly. Like, share, subscribe and comment. Join the channel membership. Join my mentorship badge. Do not miss this opportunity. And yes, tomorrow is the free webinar. Do join for the free webinar. And you can also be part of my Signals channel and of my webinar series as well. Thank you very much. See you again tomorrow with weekly updates. Do like, share, subscribe and comment. Have a great profitable trading day ahead. Thank you.